congenital heart disease. Common congenital heart diseases are described in this chapter. Usual cases selected in the examination are VSD, ASD, PDA, phallotetralogy, coarctation of aorta. Others, pulmonary stenosis, tricuspid regurgitation are sometimes selected. A brief note on congenital heart diseases. Any defect or malformation in one or more structures of the heart or blood vessels that occurs during pregnancy is called congenital heart disease. It affects about 1 in 100 babies. This may remain asymptomatic or symptoms may appear after birth, at childhood or in adults. Now, causes of congenital heart diseases. Actual cause is unknown, but some factors may increase the risk of congenital heart disease. These are genetic abnormalities such as Marfan syndrome, Bijor syndromes. Chromosomal abnormalities, example Down syndrome is associated with septal defects, mitral and tricuspid valve defects. Turner syndrome is associated with coarctation of aorta. Maternal alcohol abuse is associated with septal defects. Maternal drug abuse or drug treatment and radiation exposure. Use of thalidomide during pregnancy may be associated with amelia or paramelia. Maternal viral infections such as rubella in first trimester of pregnancy is associated with patent ductus arteriosus. Pulmonary valvular and arterial stenosis, ASD. Maternal illness, example SLE, is associated with congenital complete heart block, diabetes and phenylketonuria. Now, types of congenital heart disease. Acyanotic congenital heart disease, communication between systemic and pulmonary circulation. It is of two types, with left to right shunt, such as ASD, VSD, PDA. With no shunt, coarctation of aorta, bicuspid aortic valve, congenital aortic stenosis, pulmonary stenosis or pulmonary regurgitation, Epstein anomaly, tricuspid valvular disease. Cyanotic congenital heart disease, tetralogy of Fallot, Eisenmenger syndrome, pulmonary hypertension with right to left shunt, transposition of great arteries. Others, truncus arteriosus, tricuspid atresia, total anomalous pulmonary venous drainage. The commonest congenital heart disease is ventricular septal defect. Now, tetralogy of Fallot. Instruction by the examiner, look at the hands and legs. Now, examine the precordium. What is the likely diagnosis? Examine the CVS and what are your findings? Look at the patient carefully. There may be gross clubbing and central cyanosis. Presentation of a case, usually a child, pulse is 80 beats per minute, normal in volume, rhythm and character, JVP normal, but absent airway. On inspection, the patient may be short, dyspneic, cyanose with plethoric face. On palpation, apex feet palpable in left intercostal space, centimeter from midline, normal in character, left parasternal lift and epigastric pulsation due to right ventricular hypertrophy. Systolic thrill present in pulmonary area. On auscultation, first heart sound normal in all the areas. Second heart sound, P2 is soft or absent in pulmonary area. A2 is normal. Ejection systolic murmur is present in pulmonary area, radiates to the neck. More on inspiration. So my diagnosis is tetralogy of Fallot. What is tetralogy of Fallot? It is a cyanotic congenital heart disease which comprises of pulmonary stenosis, right ventricular hypertrophy, ventricular septal defect, perimembranous, usually large sub-aortic, overriding and juxtaposition of aorta, aortic origin 2/3 from left ventricle and 1/3 from right ventricle. Note, right ventricular outflow obstruction may be subvalvular, that is infundibular, valvular or supravalvular. Common obstruction is subvalvular either alone 50% cases or in combination with pulmonary stenosis 25% cases. What are the possible causes associated with tetralogy of Fallot? The possible causes are fetal Hyden-Toen syndrome, fetal carbamazepine syndrome, fetal alcohol syndrome, maternal phenylketonuria, Alagille syndrome, Catch-22 malformation. Now mention some cyanotic congenital heart disease. They are tetralogy of Fallot, tricuspid atresia, transposition of great vessels, pulmonary atresia, Epstein anomaly. What are the cardinal features of tetralogy of Fallot? Child with growth retardation, clubbing and central cyanosis, pulmonary ejection, systolic murmur, history of cyanotic spells during exercise, relieved by squatting. How to assess the severity of tetralogy of Fallot? In mild case, loud and prolonged murmur. In severe case, reduced or no murmur. Now, how the patient usually presents or what are the clinical features of tetralogy of Fallot? As follows, children in early age usually present with cyanotic spell, that is Fallot spell, during exertion, feeding or crying, may become apneic and unconscious. In older children, Fallot spells are uncommon, but there is more cyanosis with clubbing and polycythemia. There may be Fallot sign. Shortness of breath on exertion, easy fatigability, growth retardation, syncope, seizures, cerebrovascular events, or sudden death. What are the precipitating factors of cyanotic spells? These are exercise, stress, fever, dehydration, feeding, crying, hypoxia, acidosis. Why syncope occurs in tetralogy of Fallot? During exercise. During exercise, there is increased pulmonary resistance and reduced systemic vascular resistance. So there is increased right to left shunt and admixture of blood of right and left ventricle. As a result, there is reduced cerebral oxygenation causing syncope. Now, why cyanosis is in tetralogy of Fallot? Because of overriding of aorta, there is admixture of blood of right and left ventricles. Cyanosis is absent in newborn or early cyanotic Fallot. When cyanosis is aggravated and why? Cyanosis is aggravated during exercise called cyanotic spell or Fallot spell. It is also aggravated during feeding or crying. Cyanosis is reduced by squatting. Child may be apneic and unconscious. Syncope, seizure, cerebrovascular accident or sudden death may occur. Fallot spell is uncommon in older children. Cyanotic spell is due to increased obstruction as a result of increased sympathetic stimulation that occurs during exercise, feeding and crying. How squatting relieves cyanosis? During squatting position, abdominal aorta and femoral artery are compressed. There is increased arterial resistance, so increased pressure at the left ventricular level. Diminished right to left shunt, increased flow through pulmonary artery, so reduction of admixture of right and left ventricular blood. Why no murmur of VSD in tetralogy of Fallot? Because VSD is large, so there is equal pressure in right and left ventricle. Now, what are the complications of tetralogy of Fallot? The complications are infective endocarditis in 10% case, paradoxical emboli, cerebral abscess in 10% cases, polycythemia due to hypoxemia. It may cause cerebrovascular accident and myocardial infarction. Coagulation abnormality, right heart failure. What investigations are done in tetralogy of Fallot? Chest X-ray, it shows boot-shaped heart. Pulmonary conus is concave. Small pulmonary artery. Right ventricle is enlarged. Prominent elevated apex. Oligemic lung. Right-sided aortic arch in 25% cases. Echocardiography, 2D and color Doppler. Other investigations, ECG shows right ventricular hypertrophy, cardiac catheterization in some cases, CVC, there may be polycythemia. Now, how to treat tetralogy of Fallot? Usually, total surgical correction prior to 5 years of age, relief of the right ventricular outflow tract obstruction and closure of the VSD. If pulmonary artery is hypoplastic or anatomy is unfavorable, temporarily, blaloctalcic shunt is done. Corrective surgery is done later on. Other surgical procedures, modified blaloctalcic shunt, tubular graft between subclavian and pulmonary artery, pulmonary balloon valvuloplasty, waterstone shunt, anastomosis of the back of ascending aorta to pulmonary artery. It is performed when surgery is required under the age of 3 months. Because the subclavian artery is very small. Porse shunt, anastomosis of the descending aorta to back of the pulmonary artery. Glenn operation, anastomosis of the superior vena cava to the right pulmonary artery. Bidirectional Glenn procedure means anastomosis of both pulmonary arteries. What is Blalock Taussig shunt? It is the anastomosis between left subclavian artery and left pulmonary artery. This improves pulmonary blood flow and pulmonary artery development and may facilitate definitive surgery later on. How to detect Blalock Taussig shunt at bedside? As follows, thoracotomy star, left radial pulse is absent or feeble. Blood pressure on the left arm is absent or undetectable. Arm on the left side looks smaller than right. Note, there may be a short case in the exam tetralogy of Fallot with the Blalock Taussig shunt operation. In such case, present the case as follows. Arm on the left side looks smaller than right. Thoracotomy scar. There is clubbing with central sinuses. Left radial pulse absent or feeble. Blood pressure on the left arm absent or undetectable. There is a continuous murmur during systole and diastole in left subclavian area. Also heard posteriorly. May be confused with patent ductus arteriosus. So my diagnosis is tetralogy of Fallot with Blalock Taussig shunt operation. Now, how to treat during cyanotic spell? Knee chest position of child, high concentration of oxygen, morphine or diamorphine injection, which relaxes right ventricular outflow obstruction. Beta blocker. If medical therapy fails, emergency surgical shunt may be considered. Prognosis is good after surgery, especially if operation is done in childhood. After surgery, restenosis, recurrence of septal defect, and rhythm disorder may occur. Regular follow-up is required in every case. Now, pentalogy of Fallot. When tetralogy of Fallot is associated with ASD, trilogy of Fallot, ASD with pulmonary stenosis with right ventricular hypertrophy. Acyanotic Fallot. When tetralogy of Fallot is associated with infundibular pulmonary stenosis, outflow obstruction is mild, no cyanosis.